If you are trying to create this single page website, you would like to definitely use this kind of feature. So from the navigation bar, you would like to take your client to a specific section of your page. If you have managed to add this kind of feature, there arises one problem. How can you add that smooth scrolling effect? And also, if you have managed to get that problem solution, there arises another problem. So in this video, I'm gonna talk all about the problems as well as the solution. So watch video till the end. Hello and namaste everyone. This is Jitsaru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. Before jumping into the video, this is a single page website. So as you can see, when I click the different options in navigation bar, it will take me to the specific section. Okay, so first of all, we'll learn how to add that kind of feature. As you can see, I have already created this all the codes. Okay, I have even the anchor tag. So for the anchor tag, you can see we can give href attribute. In that href attribute, we can give the specific targeted elements of the same page. So in order to give that, we can use something like id. So for that, I'm using hash home, and also for the about, let's give hash about. And now what you need to do is that I'm targeting to the home section here. So for the div, I'm giving id home, and also let's give id about for this h2 heading. So now in the browser, when I click at about, you can see it is taking me to exactly at the about section. And now when I click to the service, portfolio, blog, as you can see, this is not taking me to the targeted section. So now the process is same. Okay, I want to show you something. If you are giving the location, as you can see, we have already given the location in href. And in the browser, you can see when I click, it doesn't take me to that specific location. So now you need to give ID as well, okay, for that specific section. So we are giving the ID for the specific location. And now when you click links from the navigation bar, it does take me to the specific location, but we don't want this. We want what? We want something like smooth scrolling effect. So in order to give that kind of smooth scrolling effect, as you can see, I have already linked the style.css file. So now in the style.css file for the universal selector, what you can do is that you can add the extra CSS property, something like scroll behavior. For the scroll behavior, if you give the smooth, now you can see that smooth scrolling effect. And this is exactly what we want, but there is one problem. As you can see, if you are using the sticky navigation bar, there is no doubt it will take you to that specific location, but there is a huge problem. There won't be any gap between the sticky navigation bar and that targeted specific section. So in order to solve that problem, again you can give the scroll padding 12. So I'm giving 4 rem. As you can see, now there is proper gap between the sticky navigation bar and that targeted specific section. And yeah, you might have seen different website like there is an extra feature, something like scroll to top feature. Now with the help of this same technique, you can add that scroll to top feature, okay, and it works in the same way. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you haven't already yet, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn, so keep learning.